Going live in 11 seconds.
Three. Three, two, one. Places. Quiet on the set. Hi, this is Howard. I'll be your host for the next almost 4 hours as we navigate the Great American Songbook, along with my co-host and president of WBIG-TV, Ryan Lysars.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to our broadcast, especially you rerun watchers out there.
That's right. We're addressing really just the rerun watchers right now because there is a slight delay before this is visible to the viewing public. As we call this Lounge Academy session to order.
I like that microphone you got over there.
Well, thank you. I do too. This was gifted to me by our own official WBIG-TV engineer, George Apfel.
Wow.
And Kevin Hayes from Buffalo Reuse. George brought it over and presented it to us at the booth. At our public reception booth that we keep out in front of this studio here. And
it's incredible.
It is. It's a great mic, and I think it's really improved our sound. It's transistorized, it says on it. This is a new feature too. I'm going to plug in. This is the modern meets the old. And no, I'm not talking about Richard Lambert, Paul Cambria. We're talking about this old Turner microphone. I'm going to switch. Here we go. Our Turner microphone here, right next to our USB rig. That sounds wonderful, Paul Cambria.
I agree, even though I don't know what it is.
Richard Lambert's here, ladies and gentlemen. And whenever Mr. Show Business enters a piano bar, they play Misty. The Lounge Academy is no exception to that rule. I can remember how it goes. And Jack Ruby shared the tastes with Richard Lambert. He's Richard Lambert, and he's Mr. Show Business. It's like all of a sudden the stars are realigned. Last week was kind of an oddball week, Ryan Lysars. Even though Mary's not at the piano side right now, so that's a little weird.
I would imagine last week was weird because I wasn't here.
It was very weird, and the whole night was weird. But it was a nice weird. We had a great time, but it was just it was just way different than, you know, every week is different because we never know.
Right, there are no 2 weeks that are the same.
No, they're like snowflakes. A lot of our guests are like flakes. That's what makes it interesting. That's the beautiful thing about show business. We're all a little flaky, right, Melissa Grace?
The thing that I find...
Speaking of Darlene, our Darlene. Oh. Hi, Darlene.
Hi, Darlene.
Nice to see you lounging with us. And yes, that's right, Barry. Misty. How's your back? How's your, if you don't mind me asking, in front of all these people? I think they all care about the same
issue, make sure you're all right.
Of course.
We're going to be here till we're going to be here. Going to talk kind of, you know, properly. You know what I mean? Proper. What do you call that? What do you call that, all you theater people out there? Is that elocution? The way you get your words out, or does that mean something else? Electrocution? With all these wires around here, that could happen too.
You need your proper electrocution.
You have to have your proper electrocution so that people can understand you, not just when you're singing, but when you're just talking. Guten Abend. I'm not sure what that means. I'll look it up. I'll Google it.
The thing that strikes me is that I only missed 1 week, and 2 weeks ago when we were sitting here at this time, it was light outside and there was sun, and now it's dark.
You're right. Is it supposed to change that fast?
And we haven't even gone back for falling back for the daylight savings time.
No.
So we're really coming into the fall, winter season.
Quickly.
Lounge Academy.
The darkness is coming earlier and earlier. I mean, you're right. Yeah, now it's back to the way I usually think of Lounge Academy.
Right.
Where it's dark out.
We were just commenting on how it should be dark at this time, and it wasn't. And now look, it's dark.
Good evening, Christine. Christine Santoro, ladies and gentlemen. And Nancy Cardillo, who's now referred to as the married one. Congratulations once more. You might be wondering where Mary is. It's no big deal. She's at the Statler. We were just at the Statler, and we finished up, but we've got a special, big special guest.
Right.
Mary's kind of playing her handler.
Yes. Mary would not leave our special guest behind. That would not be right, you know?
No.
It's not what we do here.
We don't want to leave her behind. Behind. And of course, we're talking about Justine Jopp, ladies and gentlemen.
Who, as you will see, is wearing a lovely orange dress.
That's perceptive of you, you know. You're right, she was wearing an orange dress.
Yes.
I, like most guys, would just not do well, like, being called to identify people to, like, a police sketch artist. You know? I more record their innermost feelings rather than the superficiality of if they just got a haircut or had a mustache or not. She does not have a mustache. I did notice that. Justine Jopp does not. And she's multi-talented. And she's not only, you know, a great decoration for Lounge Academy. I think we'd all agree on that, right? The camera loves Justine Jopp, as do the Lounge Cadets. She always, you know, unleashes a new talent, like selling cars.
Yes, it's incredible.
And our very own Matt Chavez is with us. How are you, sir? It's always a pleasure. Speaking of married guys.
Yes.
Matt got hitched recently, did he not?
I don't know. Did he?
Or is he about to? I think he did.
Let's ask him.
You know, that's a big step. I know, like, I never thought I would do it, Matt. He's grilling.
Grilling.
Grilling. Is that what you kids call it now? You newlywed crazy kids? Grilling's a good thing. He did. He did get married. I thought so. We're proud of you, Matt.
Yes, congrats.
He's quite a guy, that man. I like Matt. His name is Matt Chavez. He's grilling with some Chavettas, not to be confused with Chavez. He's got a grill he calls home, and he likes the food we all like here. He likes the lard donuts. He likes to grill.
That's the essence of this place.
It's the essence. And from Toronto, ladies and gentlemen, it's Diane Woodruff. Now, Diane is supposed to be coming to Buffalo to do a walk-on.
That would be lovely.
Again. I don't think it's this week. I think it's, is it next week? They purposely keep me in the dark so that we'll have that, well, you know, so we have that spontaneity on the show. This is unrehearsed, ladies and gentlemen. Buffalo guys, thank you so much for the smiles. Sending all their love. Sending it back, Matt, Mr. Chavez, Mr. and Mrs. Chavez. Part of the show where we're kind of questioning our own place on the planet, and in particular on Lounge Academy, where we're wondering, I wonder what guests are going to surprise us this evening.
This is my favorite part of the show.
You know, in a way, it is for me too. Maybe it is my favorite. I like our little roundtable discussions we start the show with.
Yes, and meanwhile the anticipation is building. We don't know who will walk through that door.
We don't know
who I have to let in the door because it's locked.
Did I lock it?
I don't know.
I'm going to lock the door. That'll guarantee people will come.
Right, the closed sign and the locked door.
Yeah.
If you don't have those, nobody will show up.
That is true. My instincts were correct. The door was not.
Well, see, there you go. That's why nobody's here.
Well, it's not that unusual. It's not unusual for nobody to be here right now. It's unusual for Mary to not be here.
Well,
usually the three of us are here.
She's on special assignment.
She is. She's handling Justine Jopp to make sure she doesn't stray off and not get to the studio.
Right, we need to get her back here.
She's in demand. People pull her in all kinds of directions, you know, when she's in a public place. A locked door makes good neighbors, Bill Zimmerman. That is so wise. Nice to see GT here. How's the signals, GT? Everything good? Your Turner mic seems to be working pretty good here for us.
Hello, GT. Come down and see us sometime, will ya?
He's going to buy a place close to us just so he can be in Lounge Academy as a regular player again. Regular Lounge Academy playhouse player. Well, this is the part of the show where, you know, we usually, like, get set up and get everything working, but it's all working. I've got my drink.
Yeah, you've had surprisingly few technical difficulties tonight with that.
That is true.
With that tablet there.
I took some memory out of it. Maybe it needed more memory. This is the first time using a USB with it, so I thought that would probably, like, throw everything off.
Maybe that's what you needed all along.
Maybe. Yeah. Barbara Fisher. Is
it's Barbara Fisher. Barbara Fisher. Ask a baby not to cry. It's Barbara Fisher.
How are you, Barbara? It's great to have you here with us for another edition of Lounge Academy.
Hello, Barbara Fisher. What store are you in tonight?
Yeah, good point, Barry. You just take it easy and make sure you get your money's worth out of that little procedure you had done. We need you in good shape for the 2020 season.
When does that start?
Well, I guess in 100.
Does it go according to real time, or is it like automotive model years?
No, we live stream here, so yeah. No, it's not like we're not like automotive model years. How did they ever get away with that, setting their own?
No, not now. It
calendar.
Doesn't even. There is no standard for it. It used to be like September, then all of a sudden it was the new year. But now it's just whenever you feel like it.
So are the new 2020s out?
Some of them have been out for months. Some of them are not out yet. Some of them just came out. It's a free for all.
I just brought out my 69.
I think legally you can sell a vehicle of the next model year beginning in January of the preceding year.
I see. It's very confusing.
For instance,
this is a conversation Justine Jopp could help mop up when she gets over here.
The 2001 Oldsmobile Aurora debuted in January of 2000.
Huh? That was quite a car, too.
Fun fact.
Now, Barbara Fisher she's home tonight. She's in North Carolina, and she's packing. I'm glad we could help you pack with our, show. And she's heading for New York on Monday. Are you going to be going to the piano cabaret bars? Like the Cafe Carlyle? Last time she took us in there and watched us while she was in the Cafe Carlyle.
We could
say we played the Cafe Carlyle.
She should come here.
Why? Absolutely, but I don't want to be... I don't want to... pester.
Well,
I know she wants to be here.
The Cafe Carlyle is an okay substitute for Lounge Academy.
Yeah, I'd say. The 69, it's a 69 AMX American Motors. Two-seater, big block. And my designated drinker is tuning in, Brian McLaughlin. How are you, sir? David Souter. Is there any questions from the lounge cadets tonight that are tuning in?
We should
probably start rolling with all the songs.
We should have a Q&A night one of these times.
A Q&A night. That's a good idea.
Or we could have like an advice show.
We could give advice. I think we've got a lot of life experience between us. We're kind of good at different things,
Right.
I don't think there's any overlapping with our abilities.
No, not much.
She is going to the Carlyle. She calls it the Carlyle.
Well, that's what the regulars call it.
She'll play a rerun. I know you can't wait to be back, Barbara.
Is Woody Allen going to be there?
Is Woody Allen going to be there at the Cafe Carlyle? Is he still playing out?
I don't know. I thought he was there at one time.
What a history that place has. Mostly because of Bobby Short. Now, the big question for all time is Bobby Short or Jackie Jocko? Who was, if there was a king?
Well, I think just by virtue of who and where we are, I'm going to have to go with Jackie Jocko, but...
Well, I do too, but I you know... You know, I think there could be an honest... You know,
yeah.
The thing is, a lot of the people that followed, and there were a lot of people, followed each of them and didn't really follow... You know, it's like, they're very loyal, you know? Like, my dad smoked Winston's.
Right.
And my Uncle Jake smoked Camel Regular. And they would... I don't remember them ever borrowing a cigarette from each other. I mean, they'd go to the store and say, I'll be right back. And then come back instead of just saying, you know, yeah, I'll have one of yours.
You wouldn't do that, no.
So I think that's how it is with lounge pianists. Oh, Woody is playing on Monday.
Oh, wow.
And she's waitlisted.
Amazing.
Wow, that's great. That'd be exciting to see him. I mean, I know he just, like, I think he just sits there and plays like he's just one of the, you know, I don't think he, like, shows off or, like, starts doing bits. But it's just, you know, just to see that.
I'd like to see that. I should add that to my bucket list. Well, it's not really my bucket that I'm worried about so much as Woody Allen's bucket, but still.
What about Woody Allen's bucket?
Well, I'm running out of time to see Woody Allen, so I should put it on my bucket list.
Oh,
but
yeah.
A bucket list is like what you do before you die, but...
Yeah, well, none of us know that's happening.
I could go next week.
All we know is it hasn't happened. Nice to see Gretchen Krakow, one of the great lounge cadets, of course. Better go on. Maybe we better play some music.
That might be why people are here.
It could be. I just never can really accept that.
Or maybe not.
Why? Why shouldn't I take a chance when romance passes by? Why shouldn't I know of love? Got this song from Guy Valeri. Why wait around when each age has a sage who has found that upon this earth, love is all that is really worth thinking of. It must be fun, lots of fun, to be sure when day is done, that the hour is coming when you'll be kissed, and then you'll be kissed again. All debutantes say it's true, and every and far Hollywood seem to give it a try. So why shouldn't I why shouldn't I Why shouldn't I? And I shouldn't leave Guy Valeri off that list of top tier.
I was just thinking that.
No way.
Where does he fall?
Right there. He's right there.
It's just kind of like you said, do you smoke Winston's, Camels, Marlboros?
Yeah. Except with those guys, you get, you know, a lot from each of them, you know, where, you know, maybe people should have smoked all three brands of cigarettes.
Well, that's me. When I used to smoke cigarettes, I didn't believe in brand loyalty. Every pack or every carton would be different.
Based on what's on sale?
Just for the sake of being different. I wanted variety, as much variety as I could get.
Wow.
Whereas your typical smoker,
great philosophy on life.
They have a brand and they stick to it. So in the realm of lounge performers, I guess I would have experienced all of them and liked them equally.
Tell us what brand cigarette you smoked.
If anybody smoked Bel Airs, I will be impressed.
Oh, really? Was that a challenging cigarette? Was that a menthol?
Yes, it was a menthol, and it's also a forgotten cigarette and a discontinued cigarette.
I like the name.
It had clouds on the package.
Yeah, it sounds kind of, you know, highfalutin.
I was kind of wondering who smoked those, you know.
Did women smoke? No, it was men smoked Bel Air, right? Sophisticated men. I think it was a kind of sophisticated brand image, wasn't it? Was it not?
Yeah, I was never sophisticated enough to pull it off.
A cool thing to, you know, I haven't seen anybody do this in a long time, probably because they'd smash the car, because a pack of cigarettes is worth like $400 now. It's worth more than stealing the tires. But we used to, you know, especially if you did not smoke, you'd grab a pack of like Camel regulars. Because
with no filter?
The hard guys. Yeah. The hard guys smoke Camel.
With no filter.
No filter.
Like Paul regulars. Hall with no filter.
That's what a regular is, right? Regular. My Uncle Jake. He had hair coming out of him everywhere. That's how regular guy he was. And you'd leave a pack on your dashboard. I used to do that on my Oldsmobile, just to look hard. Yeah. And I remember David Van Stone, who knows, he might be listening tonight, my lifelong and childhood friend. I remember one time he came to visit, and I still had that Oldsmobile, and it only had like half of an exhaust system, so you really got fumed out of the car. There was no way. And like, you know, you open the windows and it would just make it worse.
Right.
It would suck more in. And he borrowed my car, and he said it got so bad he lit one of those cigarettes. Because it seemed like fresh air compared to those fumes. It's past. I'm beginning concerned about Paul Kokoda.
Yeah, where's
my chief pilot engineer, chief engineer, navigator? He might not be coming unless he's there. Unless there's a holdup at the pizza joint.
I was just gonna say.
Literally, there might be a holdup. It's on Niagara Street.
Ricotta's on Niagara.
We'd like to thank Ricotta's on Niagara for the fine pizzas they've been sending over, and for sending over Paul Kokoda with them. Is there any songs you guys want to hear from old stuff? Here's one. Hey, Zach's out there. We better get busy. No more goofing off. This heart of mine was doing very well. The world was fine as
far as Zach could tell. Suddenly I met you, and I dreamed of gay amour. At dawn I woke up singing sentimental overture. This heart of mine is dancing gaily now. I taste the wine of real romancing now. This crazy world has taken on a wonderful design. As long as life endures, it's yours, this heart of mine.
Restaurant week could be
throwing a wrench in the works.
Yeah, but we could get an after dinner rush.
An after dinner, yeah.
I didn't think about restaurant week, but I was at my favorite midweek haunt, and it was surprisingly uncrowded. And then I was informed that maybe nobody was there because of restaurant week. I didn't really think anybody went to restaurant week, but. Could be.
Now, does Kmart have a snack bar? I don't think they do.
Not anymore. Well, not around here. I've been trying to do some research into this. I have identified at least three locations with a Little Caesars inside, but as far as the traditional Kmart cafe, they may exist somewhere, but I have not identified.
See, now, ladies and gentlemen, he's been researching that, whether or not Kmart has food service. And this is the first time he and I have ever broached this subject, yet he was already on it. That's how he got to be the president of WBIG-TV. He can anticipate trends.
Yes, I've done a lot of research into this, you know.
You have.
I remember when Kmart used to have the traditional cafeteria style food where you'd grab a tray and you'd get Salisbury steak, instant potatoes, and some peas. But those days ended, and
maybe that's what did them in.
Many of them converted to a Little Caesars format, but there were still some, like in West Seneca, where you could get your traditional hot dogs and burgers and pizza and breakfast foods. You could get scrambled eggs, bacon, and they were known for their all-you-can-eat pancake special.
Wow, Kmart. We have our own Kmart historian here, as you can see.
Yeah, don't get me started on Kmart.
We'll do a separate show for that. It's nice to see Tom O'Hara lounging tonight, sir. And our own Bob Coster. I think it's a thumb. It's hard to tell with these glasses. This is the smallest house cast I think we've ever had it at this hour.
Well, it's not even 8 yet.
It's not even 8.
After
yeah.
Everybody finishes with their discounted dinner,
well, that's
they're
true.
They're gonna flood in.
And you know, and we haven't been streaming. We've only been streaming for, a year and a half. which is only a short part of our long history. And before live streaming, we just wouldn't have started yet.
Right.
We'd be sitting there stuffing our faces and would not be aware of this. So yeah, this may not be unprecedented.
Yeah, we just can't sit around and stuff our faces anymore.
No, because the thing clicks on automatically. Right, Kim? Reifenberg and Bill Jenkins, they know how this works.
Those are some people I know. Welcome, Kim and Bill.
Okay, now we're talking. Here comes Paul Kokoda. He parks where the FBI parks across the street.
Does he have something with him?
He's opening the hatch of his vehicle.
I hope there's a pizza.
Either that or he'll have like a ton of wings.
Yeah, but it's pie night.
Oh, it's pie night. So pizza pie would qualify.
He was informed of this.
He's screwing around. Now he's back leaning into his driver's door.
Such a suspense.
I see a pizza box, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
If I had the booth camera wired in, I'd be able to switch to it, but I do not.
That was close.
Well, you better let him in.
I thought we might not have a pizza tonight. On pie night.
Our ricotta pizza's here. Nice to see Mr. Cole back, sir. David, nice to see you. As you can see, there's this is the pizza cam right there. Nice to see you, Paul Dakota. Very good. Paul always hits the ground running when he gets here. He knows right what he's got to do. Well, this time he's heading for the men's room. That counts. Usually goes right for the fridge. That looks like a beautiful ricotta pizza from Niagara Street. Diane Elizabeth. Looks wonderful tonight. She looks like a pizza. So good. 716-768-8966 if you'd like a pizza just like ours. Tom Lounge Academy sent you. Maybe you get a discount. See, now Paul's not going to let me screw around with this. He's going to come up with some zinger songs.
The fun and games are over.
Fun and games are over. And how? Now David Vernon's in the lounge. One of my favorite singers. All you lounge cadets out there, check out some of David Vernon's. I know most of you have, but dig some David Vernon. He's on Facebook, and there's links to his albums and CDs and things, and videos that he's done. And he does some really nice stuff with Alex Leonard, too. Those are some of my favorite things. And how you doing, David? Nice to see you, sir. He's also a fashion designer. He's just an all-around, ultra, hyper-creative guy. Right?
That's what we like to see.
He's just
pure.
He's pure creativity. Everything's original. Everything he touches. His music. Sounds like nobody else. His fashion designs are like nobody else. because nobody else can do it the way he does it. Well, maybe we'll pick some songs out to kind of preempt Paul Kokoda's requests.
Oh, I got one.
You could pick something.
Howard's got one. One.
What is it?
This is Always.
What a great song to start with.
Do you know it?
Yeah, it's a very, very hipsterish song.
Oh. Isn't that a great one?
It is.
That's Harry Warren, by the way.
Oh, wow. Amazing. How do you write something like that?
He did it countless times.
Is it in that book?
See, now this is a song I would normally do like at the end of the night when I'm really in the zone. You know, so it'll be fun getting into the zone very early.
Fine, it's good. You don't have to hurry because it's just three of us.
Will do, David. For now. We're holding that fort down. I've been thinking up some more songs that I'm going to request for David Vernon on his... He's on this music service, one of these apps. I was going to join it, David Vernon. Well, I'll talk to you about it when you get back. Let me know when you're back. Sometimes this is always. Melissa Grace is here, ladies and gentlemen. And Jack, we're in luck tonight.
Where's
this
Mary?
Isn't maybe.
Don't tell me Mary's not here.
She's on her way.
Oh, okay.
Always.
She's just handling one of our guests down at the stand.
This. This is love, the real beginning of forever. This isn't just midsummer madness. A passing glow of moments glad. Yes, it's love. I knew it from the night that we met. You tied the string around my. So how can I forget you? With every kiss, I know that this is always.
Suburban.
It's an amazing song.
Who was the lyricist, Ruben?
Gordon.
Oh, yeah, that was later then.
I learned this one from, well, I never learned it, obviously. But I'm familiar with it because of Chet Baker and because of Chet Baker's girlfriend.
Did Chet Baker do that song?
Yeah.
Boy, he had such
so
great
did his
taste.
Girlfriend.
Did he?
Yeah. He sang like his trumpet lines. It was the same phrasing, you know, that's what came out of him.
Just singing that song.
I suspected you might know that.
Well, yeah. Well, obviously, I don't know it, but I'm familiar with it, and I love the song.
So do I.
T-Bone's with us. Right. Nice to see you, Jack. Looking good.
You look great.
You guys look like a health poster.
Yeah. You're so sweet.
Not that you shouldn't.
No.
It's not like you looked like crap last time or anything.
No.
Oh. But you look great. Don't they, everybody? Well, let me give you a better look here. You're tired of looking at the pizza, I'll bet. She's due.
I told her we were going to be allowed.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'll rise. It's Robert Dower, ladies and gentlemen. He's a man of the cloth. And we're blessed to have Robert in the house tonight. He's a big conductor. On the periodic table of the elements, he's such a good conductor. See how these people inspire me? Teresa Vita. What a great musical. Beautiful sounding name that is. Therese Vita. Wonderful having you with us.
Too many people spilling on the piano?
Yeah, the moisture is taking its toll. It's shellac, you know, it's old-fashioned shellac, so it turns white and it starts to like freak out.
Right.
So.
No.
You're my old-fashioned shellac.
You're so good.
I would have put a tie on and a jacket. And I apologize.
Well,
but my wife doesn't keep my clothes.
But you do look sharp, though. I
totally lying.
I wish I could tell you look like garbage because you're not wearing a tie. But
Darn it, I gotta admit, you still pull it off somehow.
He's totally lying.
He's lying?
He's saying that I don't keep his clothes clean and pressed.
If you're feeling fancy free, are you feeling fancy free, Jack?
Oh, yeah.
Come wander through the world with me.
I'm confessing things.
I don't keep the laundry clean because he won't let me do the laundry.
Till the real thing
comes along. I gladly move the earth for you to prove my love, dear, and its worth to you. If that isn't love, it's gonna have to do till the real thing comes along. With all the words, dear, at my command, I just can't make you understand. I'll always love you, darling, come what may. My heart is yours, what can I say? I'd sigh for you, I'd cry for you, I'd tear the stars down from the sky for you. If that isn't love, it's gonna have to do. Till the real thing comes along. Steve Corbett talking about the real thing coming along. Nice to see you, sir. I should have asked you who did this one.
I don't know.
This is
ask you.
Like a whole roofing crew did it. I don't recognize any of the names.
Do you have the names?
Man Hollinger, Alberta Nichols, Sammy Kahn. So he did it.
He did the work.
Sal Chaplin and Ellie Freeman.
Okay.
That's why we're at Lounge Academy. We learn new things.
Let's invite that committee back.
Yeah. Probably we're just getting together drinking or something and playing poker and wrote the song. Right, Karen Lizzie? And Richard Cannamella, my old school chum. Hank Mancini, Two for the Road. Picking on some new material here. Do we know this one?
Yes.
I better not. I may have never heard it.
The permission in this book is no, seriously.
Yes.
Somebody got it.
starlit skies when you're alone. The magic moonlight dies at break of dawn. There is no sunrise when your lover has gone. What lonely hours, the evening, morning, spring. What lonely hours, what memories lingering. Like fallen flowers, life can't mean anything when your lover has gone. That's a question we've all been trying to answer.
Will it be a new song to us to fill us in on the end?
It's kind of like pie.
Does she ever come back?
There are no signs of
it. It's like pie.
Yeah.
The math formula. There's no. No. That's the way I interpret it.
I think she's coming back.
I think he's screwed. You're at Lounge Academy right now. That's the where or when. Nice to see Janice Schlau. Welcome. We got some viewer mail that we're going to hear tonight's episode, ladies and gentlemen, including, speaking of Janice Schlau, some viewer mail from Janice Schlau. We're going to be opening to show you. So we'll tease you with that to keep you around. Seems we stood and talked like this before. We looked at each other with that same way then, but I can't remember where or when. But I can't remember where.
Okay, I have no idea.
Or when. Some things that happen for the first time seem to be happening again.
Rick's in the house, ladies and gentlemen. What a group.
What a great group you have.
It's amazing tonight. All the babies are here tonight. It's a full show business audience tonight. Well, they're all cadets. Miss Jones. Someone said as we shook hands, she was just Miss Jones to me. Then I said, Miss Jones, you're a girl who understands. I'm a man who must be free. And all at once I lost my breath. All at once was scared to death. All at once I owned the earth and I own the sky. Now I've met Miss Jones, and we'll keep on meeting till we die. Miss Jones and I. What are the beautiful songs, isn't it? Song that means a lot to me.
Nobody appreciated these songs when they were going big time.
Is that right?
It's Chet Baker.
Chet Baker did this one?
Typical of Sinatra. He followed. You know, he did everything everybody else did.
Miss Jones, wherever you are.
Doctor, you used to do this all the time. Remember Doris Jones?
Of course.
That was,
it was written
that
for
was her. Song.
I know it. He told me I better learn it for her, too. That's why I learned it. One of these days, she'll walk through the room and surprise us. Paging Ryan Weissers to the piano. The beautiful dancers in the room. We'll pick out something nice for them. Yeah. Here's something for them. Your eyes don't shine like they used to shine. They were once inspired.
like they used to shine. And that thrill is gone when your lips, touch mine. I'm afraid the masquerade is over. And so is love. And so is love. The world don't need what they used to mean. They were once inspired. Now they're just. Just routine. I'm afraid the masquerade is over. And so it's love. Guess I'll have to play Hayachi and get myself a clown's disguise and learn to laugh like Hayachi with tears in my eyes. You look on the dance floor. It's really a who's who here tonight. Barbara Fisher, Jack Morrow, Barbara Fisher, thunder, let a million ferns go under, I am not concerned with stocks and bonds that I've been burned with. I love you and you love me, and that's how it will always be, and nothing else can ever mean a thing. Who cares what the public chatters? Love's the only thing that matters. The sky should I care? Life is one long jubilee. So long as I care for you, then you care for me.
Gershwin and Gershwin. Thank you, Jack. Thank you, sir. Jack's our Gershwin guy. It's a great song. Switching over to a little Cy Coleman. I'm sentimental, so I walk in the rain. Got some habits even Barbara Fisher can't explain. I'll head for the corner, turn up and stay. Why try to change me now? I'll sit and I'll daydream. I've got daydreams galore. Cigarette ashes, there they go on the floor. I'll go away weekends, leave the keys in the door. Why try to change me now? Why can't I be more conventional? Like Dave Corbett's. People talk, people stare, so I try. That's not for me, 'cause I can't see my kind of crazy world. Go passing me by, so let people wonder, let them laugh, let them frown. You know I love you till the moon's upside down. Don't you remember I was always your clown? Why try to change me? Why try to change me? Why try to change me now? I believe you're right about that. Carol Lee and Cy Coleman. Written for Frank Sinatra. For his last album on Columbia. Watching Lounge Academy. Hi, Lou Birdie. Nice to see you, sir. Thanks for lounging with us. We'll be lounging till 11 o'clock, lounge time here in Buffalo. We start at 7:15 every Friday. We work our way through what they now call the Great American Songbook. They used to just call these songs back in our parents' day. These were the great songs, some of the greatest artistic triumphs of America. And that makes you a lounge cadet. Here's a Rodgers and Hart song. We used to do this one years ago. Andy Jones used to request this one. Though I know every needs every day, and we
have changed since the last time. To my joy and delight, it's a new kind of love at first sight. Oh, it's you and it's I all the time. Every meeting's a marvelous pastime. Even though it's increasingly sweet, ever be happy to me. I greet you. With a song in my heart, I behold your adorable face. Just a song at the start. But it soon is a hymn to your grace. When the music swells, I'm touching your hand. It tells me you're standing near. Heaven opens its portals to me. Can I help but rejoice? Let a song such as ours aim to be what it always knew. I would
classic. Spring is here. As long as we're pretending spring is here, it kind of is the way the weather is. This is for Kathy Moses. I always think of Kathy Moses when I think of spring arrival. How could you not?
If I looked at you, and begin to sing.
Thank you, Janice.
I'm not as crazy as I seem to be. After all, if I collect bits of straw and string, I'm only doing what those robins do. After all, it's spring. If I dream out loud when we're in a crowd and forget the time of day, darling, bear with me. When they stare at me and remark the gold and April Fool's Day. And if I hear bells, but there's no such thing,
star-studded. I'll give you a direct shot, ladies and gentlemen. There they are. It's a special night here in Lounge Academy. Hopefully it's a special Lounge Academy night for all the Lounge Cadets, because it's pie night. It's the night we all eat pie. Mary's... I'm going to take you now.
Well, no, it's not marked.
It doesn't burn calories doing this
stuff. As you can see, Mary's shaking it up.
I felt like I had a
vibe. She's shaking it up, baby. She's shaking. She's actually making whipped cream out of a cow. There's a chunk of cow in there. That's the way we do things here.
It's getting there.
Look at her go.
One piece of pie with a cream. You'll have the best piece of pie.
I already ate my pie.
You already ate your pie. So you're going to have some of that whipped cream for sure. You don't even need pie to eat the whipped cream.
I believe that.
Oh, thank you, Vicky. Gaia, I get to call her Gaia. You're too kind, Gaia. Thank you for that, for the generous support of Lounge Academy.
Where did you get the freezer?
It's doing well, but it's not quite there. Yeah, I wonder if we should chill.
Stick around, because we're going to have viewer mail tonight a little later, featuring Janice's letter. I already know what's in it. I'm trying to contain myself here so I don't give it away.
I'll just have another.
Thank you very much, Janice. Really,
it's court night.
Well, I'll talk about that later. I don't want to get overly emotional right now. I won't be able to sing these emotional songs.
Let's see what we got here.
I'll probably be hyper tomorrow.
Yeah, it goes with the shake here. Because we're working on
okay.
A topic for all of Python. Yeah,
it is.
We need a beat.
Oh, I thought it was too much.
I'm sorry.
You can always go downtown.
You better chuck that. I think it's probably a count by now.
Was that
all right? So I have a little bit of shaking. She's in the top. All right, I had to shake her.
If it is, I did not know that.
Wait, come on.
Get the music going. All right, what are you? We got a new producer of the show, ladies and gentlemen.
I love this.
This shows up every okay. 4 weeks, 5 weeks.
It's been longer than that.
Well, this is going to be a slow shake.
It's been like 3 months.
Like a fool.
Well, it's too slow.
I believe what I want to believe. Just break it up into 30-second notes. My foolish house.
64
what foolish hearts can see. I thought I found a miracle. I thought that you adore me. But it was not a miracle. It was a merely whipped cream before me. You are too beautiful, my dear, to be true. Really? I am a fool for beauty, fooled by a feeling, once I had found you, I could have bound you to. You are too beautiful for one man alone. One lucky fool to be with. When there are other men with eyes of their own to see with. Love does not stand sharing. Not if one cares. Have you been comparing my every kiss with theirs? If on the other hand I'm faithful to you, it's not through a sense of favorite song.
That was a movie rather than
a show?
No, it was rather than a Broadway. Mm-hmm. See, I may have mentioned you. Rodgers and Hart have been there for 2 years and I really didn't like it. And they went back to New York and started playing musical. But that came from
a what a story.
That never went anywhere. That's why nobody knows that song.
Are you
going to
be our first taste tester just for
sure? It's wonderful to see a guy. It's great to see Tom Capo in the lounge tonight, sir. As always. Derek Nye, nice to have you here with us. You go to my head, and you linger like a haunted refrain. This goes out to Mari McNeil. She made the song famous. And I find you spinning round in my brain like the bubbles in a glass of cheap champagne. To my head like a sip of sparkling burgundy brew, and the very mention of you like a kicker in the big wazoo. A spell over me. Still I say to myself, self, get a hold of yourself. Can't you see this will never be? Go to my head with a smile that makes my temperatures rise. Summer with a thousand Julys, you intoxicate me with the soul in your eyes. Oh, it's certain that this heart of mine hasn't a ghost of a chance in this crazy romance. Right here at Lounge Academy. We miss a McNeil. Oh, yeah. We haven't had McNeil here in a while since the theater season started. The whipped cream is done, ladies and gentlemen.
Mary's going to heaven on bailing.
This whipped cream is dedicated to our own Justin Jerk.
To her of Albert.
Nice to see you, sir.
Yay! Look at this!
Jeff DeLita, we've got fresh whipped cream here. I'm not sure what they're going to do with it. They ate all the pie.
I've never had whipped cream on pizza.
This could get creative.
I'll give it a shot.
Yeah. Might be like inventing the chicken wing. Here's one we've never done. It's a nice song. Connor, you took advantage of me. I'm a sentimental fool, that's all. What's the use of trying not to fall? I have to wait. You made your kill. You took advantage of me.
like an apple on the bow, bow, bow. Bow, apple on the bow, bow. The bow of a tree. I've got an apple tree. And we got apples hanging there. They're delicious. They're on the bow. What's the you gonna shake me down somehow? What's the use? You cooked my goose. You took advantage of me. I'm so hot and bothered that I don't know my elbow from my ear. I suffer something awful each time you go, and much worse when you're near. Here I am with all my bridges burned, just a babe in arms, where Justine's concerned. You lock the door, call me yours, on account of you took advantage of me. But when you buy a car, she'll never take advantage of you. Unfortunately. It's not a package deal. It's not part of the extended service plan. But every time it breaks or you want it, your recall's taken care of, she's there. She'll make the process more pleasant for you. It already is. How's the whipped cream, South Dakota? The homemade. This is lounge made whipped cream.
This is corrections on how to be a happy camper. So follow this.
He had a real honest reaction. Song for my cat. You'd be so. At the other location. Yeah.
He's not a lounger.
Well, I only took him for, you know, he acts like a real tough guy, you know. But then I took him for a car ride to the vet.
Oh, yeah.
He knows that. He knows where he's going.
He wasn't happy with that.
Well, I don't think he couldn't have known where he was going because it was the first time. But he was so used to being, you know, in our home.
They don't like going anywhere.
He was flipping out. Yeah, he was just he didn't trust, but you know, thought I was gonna play some really horrible practical joke on him. Next time I'll bring the cinder block on the car seat. I think that might have been it. You'd be so nice to come home to. You'd be so nice by your block. You can breathe on high, singing lullaby. You'd be all I could desire. With the stars chilled by the winter, August moon burning above. You'd be so nice. You'd be paradise to come home to and love and feed and play with. Cats are great, aren't they?
They are.
Three, wow.
We have three, what a team that must be.
We had four.
You've got three now?
Yeah, we got three. Wow. We lost my old girl about a year and a half ago.
No, sad. Yeah. They're all such individuals. You never can get older than them.
We got one that we really, well, she's now wearing a flea collar, but I'm wearing a couple of slashes.
Oh.
Emmy, yeah.
Good job getting that on.
Yeah. One of them goes out. Our male goes out because he's our mole.
We're talking about cats, ladies and gentlemen.
Right, but the two girls stay in, and my old girl also stayed in. They're full-time in cats. But,
yeah, there's good weight.
Outside was an indoor.
Yeah, we decided. He wasn't outdoor. He was wild, and somebody captured him. And actually, he snuck into somebody's house while they were on vacation through the little, pet door. And she came home. This was at the end of the 400, East Aurora. And he was on her couch with her other animals.
In the hinterlands.
Yeah.
So my in-laws hooked a cat up with Mary as a surprise for my birthday.
Yeah, I recognize.
Best present I ever got.
Yeah. But yeah, when you move them to a new house, you can usually bring them in. Because they don't know outside at that location. Yeah.
Oh, that would make sense.
Yeah, you can do that. Right.
You got to think like a cat, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah. I mean, when you bring them to a new location, all of a sudden they've got so much to explore in the new house that they don't realize that there's an in and out there.
Yeah. Until I married you, there was no such thing as
an indoor cat.
They're cats.
The stars.
Yes. Three would come in.
This is a great song. I remember we had a guest here.
Or two would come in.
Somebody came here and brought
a
couple with them.
Courtney goes in and out.
I can't remember whose friends they were. And the woman didn't sing, but she wanted to be a singer, and she even had music on her phone, like Facebook stuff. She's been wrestling with this, probably practicing on her own. She never sang with anybody, on the piano or anything. And she said, can we do this song? She came up and she knocked me out. It was just, she had so much authenticity, She just really had it.
This is a Harry Warren song,
Are the stars out tonight? I don't know if it's cloudy or bright. The moon may be high. I can't see a thing in the sky. And I from Dames. Nice to see Benny out there with us.
Because he didn't do musicals, so.
Got to give you back the fly on the wall split screen. Sorry about that. You were looking at my back, which is probably my best side. It's Justine John. And she was not a flop. She was a big hit on Lounge Academy. She's Justine John. She'll sell you a car. And you won't know where you're going after that. There she goes, ladies and gentlemen. Justine Jopp, everybody. How about another big round of applause for Justine Jopp? Talented percussionists here, Jeff, don't we know? For all the married men out there. I was thinking this song while I'm waiting for Mary to change her outfits a few times when we're going out somewhere.
It's the other way around for us.
If it takes forever,
night for you. For a thousand summers, I will wait for you. Till we're bed beside me, till I'm holding you, till I hear you sigh here in my arms. Anywhere you wander, anywhere you go, every day remember how I love you so. In your heart, believe what in my heart I know. Forevermore, I will wait for you. The clock is ticking away the hours, one by one. Then the time will come when all the waiting's done. The time when you return and find me here and run straight to my waiting arms. If it takes forever, I will wait for you. For a thousand summers, I will wait for you. Till you're here beside me, till I'm holding you, and forevermore sharing your love.
It's nice to see Zach on both sides of the camera. He's examining me. I'm not even sure what he's going to do with that, but he's planning something.
The sleepless nights, the daily fights. Quick toboggan when you reach new heights. I miss those kisses and I miss the bites. I wish I were in love again. The broken dates, the endless waits, the lonely loving and the hateful hates. Conversation with the flying plates. I wish I were in love again. No more pain, no more strain. Now I'm sane, but I'd rather be gaga. Hold out fur. Cats incur the fine mismating of the him and her. I've learned my lesson, but I wish that I were in love again.
The party is just getting warmed up, ladies and gentlemen.
Did you cut that short? How about the lure? The faint aroma of performing seals. Did you miss that?
Roma, faint aroma of performing seals.
How's that for a lyric?
It's amazing.
Did he copy that from you?
He must have.
That's one of the cleverest lyrics I ever heard.
I don't know if I want to be near Howard, though.
Diana Woodruff. I'm a fool to want you more.
Might as well do it in the key it's in.
I'm a fool to want you. To want a love that can't be true. To love and care for others too. I'm a fool to hold you. Such a fool to hold. mine alone to share a kiss the devil has known. Time and time again,
I don't know, I got it.
I said you'd leave, I'd leave you. Time and time again, I went away. I'm a fool to love you.
How wonderful.
Oh.
Good to see you.
It's wonderful to see you.
Brought you another book to read.
We're not like, you brought me a what?
Another book to read.
Oh, thank you.
Another dumb wife took it.
Okay, well, thanks for the tip off. I won't let her get away with it. It's great to look at the end of the piano across this expanse of music and see real show business people. Creative people. That's our signature thing, yeah. Here you go. I keep an emergency one here.
I don't know where you write out of my life. Laugh and forget this affair.
Saying how much he liked the swing book.
Yes, I was foolish to care.
Everybody loves the swing book.
I'm gonna dance you right out of my dreams. Marcy, to be carefree and gay. Guess that I'll learn to play the part. And when our friends begin. I know I'll really need my sense of humor.
Song by Cy Coleman. There's so many great songs. Paul Kokoda, it's just.
You're right. Some ways there aren't enough.
There's always more to discover. What if he would have gone into like punk rock or something?
Probably.
He would have invented it. Yeah. There'd be no punk. How many millions? Of Annabelle's and Lillian's would be to capture me.
I was looking at it.
But you had such persistence, you broke down my resistance. You fell, and it was swell. You're my big and brave and handsome Romeo. How I wonder if I shall never, never know. It's not that you're attractive, but oh, how my love grew active when you came into view. I've got a crush on you. Sweetie pie. All day and night time.
Okay, we're done.
Here beside. I never had the least bit notion that I could fall with so much emotion. Could you coo? Could you pair? Or a cunning cottage we could share? The world will pardon my mush, 'cause I've got a crush. My baby on you.
Marcy?
Down once and I saw a man.
people all lounge together, there'd be no problems in the world. Nice to have Manya here. The craziest dream.
I don't think anyone wants to see me still.
Last night. Yes, I did. I never dreamt it could be. But there you were. In love with me. I saw your lips next to mine. So I kissed him. You didn't mind it at all. When I'm awake, such a break never happened. How long can a guy go on dreaming? How long, Paul? If there's a chance that you care.
Him to write the music for first Inhabitants of Sun Valley, and then for Sun Valley Serenade, I mean, and then Orchestra Wise. Harry Warren wrote all the music, and the rest is history. Oh, but then I'm gonna take another, you know, your song.
We just talked about what we experienced and what we saw.
Who wrote it? My song?
The song you always do.
This Heart of Mine?
No, from Harry Warren. From Sun Valley Serenade.
Why?
Crazy Error. Yes, that was an error, and I think it's still up there.
But then the music took me to, they did a couple renditions by the Manhattan Transfer of that song. Did you ever hear it?
They did it like this. Why? Breezes sigh. Every evening,
with ice skaters, you can see that one.
Long before the springtime is due, and even though it's snowing, violets are growing. I know why, and so do you.
every evening, whispering your name as they do. Interesting thought.
It's going to happen, I think. It's too good a song. You can't hide that. You know how everybody jumped on it last? It last is one of the greatest songs of all time now.
You're right. You're right.
But this one, you know, this one outdid at last. They chose this one over at last.
Did this wind up on the cutting room floor?
But yeah, it lasted.
Oh, it did?
Yeah.
I didn't even realize it wasn't
the first movie.
The first one. Well, it must have made it in at some point because it says it's from orchestra wise.
They saved it last for the second movie because they said we have too many hits in this one.
Oh, right. That's right. You told me that story.
But the opportunity's there for I Know Why and So Do You.
I agree. Yeah. I was never spellbound. I wonder if they did the verse in the movie. I wonder if they even did the verse in the movie. Yeah. I was never spellbound by a starry sky. What is there to moon glow when love has passed you by? Then there came a midnight and the world was new. Now here am I, so spellbound, darling. Not by stars, but just by you.
At last.
My love has come along. My lonely days are over.
Is this orchestra woods?
It is. And life is like a song.
Orchestra Wives. Thanks, everybody. Thank you, Glenn Miller.
Oh, sorry.
Janis Joplin's out there now, ladies and gentlemen. She's up there with Barbara Fisher. Colin Lively, nice to see you. Welcome to Lounge Academy. We're here every Friday night from 7:15 to 11 o'clock, exploring the Great American Songbook, as it's called nowadays. It used to just be called songs, right, Catherine? Now that's the Great American Songbook.
Why do you play American so much?
Why do we play American so much? Watching Lounge Academy, Lounge Academy, Lounge Academy with Nick and me. Thank you. Thank you, Lounge Academy. So many songs, I don't know what to do next. Chestnut, how little we know, how much to discover, what chemical forces flow from lover to lover, how little we understand what touches off that tingle, that sudden explosion when two tingles intermingle. Who cares to define what chemistry this is? Cares with your whips on mine, what a great bliss is. So long as you kiss me and the world around us shatters, how little it matters, how little Nick knows. The creative people find each other, don't they? They're like neutrons. Those are the ones in the middle, right? The neutrons. Here's one called All My Mananas. We're going bilingual here.
I gotta run, Howard. Thanks.
Thank you, Paul Kokoda. It was wonderful of you. setting out the drums. How about another big round of applause for Paul Kokoda? He's been selecting many of the songs heard in Lounge Academy. He's our flight engineer as we fly the Great American Songbook. Nick moves in, so the bases are almost loaded.
That's what we say when all the chairs around the piano are full.
What wonderful names out there in the cadet verse, cadet verse. Make us part of your Friday night lounge. Like Jack does. Nick may not have a thing at all. Except for just a dream or two. I've got lots of plans for tomorrow. All my tomorrow. They belong to you.
And you friggin' need just
right now, it may not seem like spring at all. We're drifting, and the laughs are few. I've got lots of rainbows planned. All my tomorrow belongs to you. No one knows better than I that love keeps passing me by. That's fate. But with you there by my side, I'll soon be turning that tide. Just wait. I'll be clinging to all the dreams I dream, begging borrow. All my tomorrow, they all come true. Nick, all my bright tomorrow. Tomorrow's Nick. Thank you. Thanks, Jack. It's a pretty song, isn't it? Jimmy Van Heusen, Sammy Cowan, a couple ringers. I wonder it's so good. Yeah.
Is that the best you could do, really?
Yeah. Yeah, we're getting there. It's going to be a long night.
Jack says being a dick.
slice over there and have it afterwards. I eat afterwards.
I listen to my friendship and I'm a little person's timeline and I don't see a lot.
Yeah.
Sometimes if I do
with
find enough
cream.
Yeah,
thank you.
Right.
Right.
So all of a sudden,
sometimes
they don't.
I think it's
been
whipped.
And
yeah.
I
looked,
that might
be
half the
shoulder. I'm going to eat the pie all the way. When somebody loves you,
no,
it's no good unless she loves you. Somebody needs you. It's no good unless she needs you.
I can't make it. I can make some more. Well, I made one this morning.
have to teach you how to do it. The trick is don't play with it.
I guess so. That's true, because the pies go over it.
Pies go over it.
People aren't going to see it.
Here's a new one, Barbara Fisher.
I won't send roses.
And then some ice water. I couldn't get it to come together in the breakfast.
Or hold the door.
Tablespoons of ice water, so I had to add a few more tablespoons.
I won't remember. Which dress you wore. My heart is too much in control. The lack of romance in my soul will turn you gray. So stay away. Forget my shoulders when you're in need. Forgetting birthdays is guaranteed, and should I love you, you'd be the last to know. I won't send roses, and roses suit you so. Is frantic. My temper's cross with words romantic. I'm at a loss. I'd be the first one to agree that I'm preoccupied with me.
It's another Jerry Herman. These are from Mac and Mabel. That must have been a great show. I heard her do it.
I love that people remember this.
Yeah, she did the best one I've seen, Barbara Fisher. Sit down and join us, Kathy. I'll be tired of you when the stars grow tired of gleaming. When I am tired of dreaming. Thank you so much. Wonderful. Have a safe trip home with those pies. It's nice knowing Barry's with us. I'll be tired of you when stars grow tired of gleaming. When I am tired of dreaming.
Oh my God, they don't stop talking.
Then I'll be tired. I know it's true.
I'll just sit here and wait for you.
When winds grow tired of blowing, grass is tired of growing. Then I'll be tired of you. From day to night, till wrong is right, till the birds refuse to sing. Beyond the years, the echo of my only love will still be whispering. Whispering. If my throbbing heart should ever stop repeating, that it is tired of repeating, then I'll be tired of you. In there, Barry. That's what they tell you to do. It's Nick. It's Nick. Nick and Kathy. They're Buffalo's showbiz couple. They'll entertain you tonight. They can do comedy knockabout stuff. Good night, Kathy. Thank you so much. Thanks for bringing Nick. Have a nice week, Nick. Thank you.
He didn't sing.
He sang with you a couple of lines.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, that counts. We'll punch him in. He's a future singer.
A future singer? You heard me.
This is like the Klein Hands Music Hall. It's perfect acoustics. Is that right?
Well, I started looking at the whole of the Power's Company's red screen like I said.
Yeah, it looks great.
What? Yeah, you gotta be careful when you're in a situation like that.
Yeah, really.
It's like social media. It's like Twitter. My sweet embrace of you.
I was there once.
I think we stayed here twice. Embrace me. I think that was Mary.
I was here when
it was puppied. Yeah, I danced on it.
Embrace me.
I've heard that it's corroborated that it was
my
back there.
Sweet
I said to somebody, I seem to think the dance floor was back there. And they said, yes, that's what it was.
Embrace me, my irreplaceable you. My irreplaceable Sue. Eberhardt, that is. Just one look at you, my heart grows tipsy.
And we went back, and we were dancing on the dance floor.
You and you alone bring out the gypsy. I love all the many charms about you. Above all, I want my arms about you. Don't be a naughty baby. Come to Papa. Come to Papa Do.
I remember the trifle.
My sweet embrace. Embraceable you.
It would be
cool.
Yeah, but you're one of those like times that we Yeah,
we have to try
that sometimes. And then I have
Careful, it might be foggy out there. Especially on the Skyway. I don't think Higgins tore it down yet, did he? He's standing by it all the time. I can't wait. Yeah, I don't know why either. Well, you can, you'll find out why.
That's All Saints Day.
Afterwards. We'll see who makes all the money.
Well, it's why we never got a new piece that would have cost $20 million back in 1998.
Yeah, now the toll is $20
million.
I don't go over it either. I haven't been over there in a long time. I just don't want to bother with all this.
Well, there was, see, there was.
They've taken all the fun out of doing anything, you know? You need all these papers and all this stuff, checkpoints, and, you know, they're threatening you. They're not going to let you, if you lose a piece of paper, they're not going to let you back in the country ever. You know, it's like, who needs that? I go over there to have fun, not to worry that, like, my life's going to be over. I mean, I like Chinese food as much as the next guy, you know? But, yeah, at some point, it's not worth the hassle. Why do that when I can come here, you know, or go to my shop? It's Jack and Missy. Thank you, sir. Thanks, Jack. Keep up the good work. David Vernon is back. David Vernon is back in the house. David, I'm gonna eat a little piece of pizza, and then because you're here and we've got some wonderful guests, I'm gonna be like psyched to do some more songs.
You're gonna do some more songs for us?
Do you like this?
I'm gonna have a slice of pizza if I need some refueling.
It's the after hours.
This is where it gets good.
This is from Ricotta's is out in Orchard Park, and then
they have a branch out there. This stuff is
good. That's where they started. There are two out there.
Oh, they started out there.
Yep.
And then they went to Niagara.
They went to Niagara 2 years ago, I think. I've had their pizza. The Rex Country Store is Ricotta's.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
At least I think it's the same one.
Yeah, I think it is.
I'd like to thank.
Probably not. Maybe they have different franchises. Maybe you can buy a franchise. I don't know.
Maybe they're related and they're mad at each other.
It's like in the Louis, the foot-long hot dogs and Louis Red Hots. And yeah, I remember at the Buffalo News, you'd step on these there'd be these minefields and you'd step on the wrong thing and offend people. The Buffalo Philharmonic.
Are we being taped?
We're live.
Then I'll tell you another
thing. I was going to say, I tried everything. Yeah. He was a nice person.
table together the tables for the opening night gala.
Oh, yeah.
They can't see me, can they?
Yeah.
We should go back there.
Those, of course, that's why they're tuned in.
And I'm glad I had somebody else look at that.
Hang in there, David Vernon. Stick with us. I want to hang out with you. Reading this song. Refueling with this delicious slice of pizza, courtesy of Ricotta's on Niagara Street. 716-768-8966. If you'd like to order a pie, tell them we sent you. They know how I like it, and that's the way they make it.
Not me, they're made of the power knives, gentlemen, just that
poor little
orchestra. Just the bubble that I bought it from here. Remember our book, Orchestra?
Should have done it.
Yeah, we still should. We should now that we can.
Yeah.
Have a big cello come out with the teeth or something.
And a forward.
So I like that.
And a forward written by the ghost who lives in the Milanzi.
There you go.
I mean, it's just always struck me. It's just, the full Philharmonic is so cool because it's conductors. It's an all-star. It's about a world. What it ought to be. You know, over the years, being from Buffalo, you wouldn't think, it's really world-class.
Ricotta's Pizza, ladies and gentlemen. 716-768-8966. Thanks again for the courtesy. Yeah, I'm sorry about that.
Yeah. All right. Here it is.
Well, all roads lead to football. Jeff Delina. Did we do this one? A foggy day in Buffalo Town had me low. To do that once in a while to make sure it's working. Make sure it's that video and audio. So many options.
Not enough keys. Watching the epilogue of Lounge Academy, we call this. One of my favorite parts of the show, when a lot of the acts have packed up and left, and we're sitting around just really relaxing, basking in the pie. Us, Sheila. Sheila Black. Jeff Dolina. David Vernon. Barbara Fisher. Up at dawning. Still the taste of wine. Then I remember your mind. I've got a world that's fine. What's before me? Routines that bore me. Punch that clock and eat. But what a lucky guy I am. I've got a world that's great. Atom bombs, Cape Canaveral and false alarms. Half the universe is up in arms. So I flip a little too. I'm holding you. What's the hassle? I'll buy the castle. We can live like kings. If you remember your mind, then I've got a world that you've got a world that we've got a world that swings. To take you on a wild, wonderful adventure. Fly like a kite from space, no strings. I don't want to lose that bell that rings. Cause I've got a world that swings. I've got the world on a string. Sitting on a rainbow. Tie the string around my finger. Reminds me of mine, and I've got a world that swings. Atom bombs, Cape Canaveral and false alarms. The universe is up in arms. So
I flip a little too, until I'm holding you. What's the hassle? I'll buy the castle. We can live like kings. If you remember your mind, then I've got a world that you've got, a world that we've got, a world that swings. Janice Schlau's got a world that swings. We've got a world that swings. Okay, Barry, thanks for hanging out with us. It's been great. Do everything they tell you, you know that. Tell everything you tell you, I mean. That overlooks the food truck. Oh, thank you, Janice. Janice, you made me so happy with the surprise that you sent us, telling us how much you like Lounge Academy and putting a gift card in for some booze. Here's what she wrote. Isn't this nice? Marion Howard. Mary, you got her name first.
Oh.
Girls first.
Oh, it's a friend of mine.
You should know how much I enjoy your club on Friday evenings. Such a welcome rest between baking and cleaning.
Me, I just don't clean.
We're opening Prosit on the weekend. I'm enclosing a bottle of booze coupon which is great, because I know exactly what we knew what to buy with that, and we're gonna enjoy it and toast you. But it made me so happy that you know, you like what we're doing here, and it helps you be successful with your restaurants. You know, she's schlepping stuff and watching us
get
work done. I know that. Yeah, I've been self-employed my whole life, you know, so I can relate. Like, I used to listen to John Otto all night, you know, while I was working. I'm not putting myself in the John Otto class. That's impossible. But it kind of makes me think of that, you know, when you're working away and you can still have fun. So thank you for that thoughtful thing. You really, you have no idea how much I enjoy that type of thing. In some enchanted rendezvous that overlooks Delaware Avenue, with someone sharing all the lights, delightful chats of this and that, cocktails for two. It's going to be Mary and me drinking the booze you bought us. But I can barely read this with my glasses. That's okay, though.
joy, a cigarette. Any song with a cigarette is good for some reason. Do some exquisite chestnuts, whatever that is. Two hands are sure to meet underneath. Serviceette with cocktails for two. But my heart will be, I can't read this, kisses will be so glad we both alive. Janice's theme song. Every pianist in town plays that in or out in and out of the room. Everybody knows that. Here's one to all the authors.
I don't know. I get mixed up because they're.
Who has not written a book, right? In our circle, everybody just writes and writes and creates. This goes out to the writer of Orchestra.
Once a while ago,
if they ask me, I could write a book.
Can you help me with this argument we're having? What did this place used to be?
About the way you walk and whisper and look. I could write the preface of how we met, so the world would never forget. And the simple secrets of the plot. It's just to tell them that I love you a lot. And the world discovers, as my book ends, how to make two lovers a friend. Pete's Garage is watching. Thank you, Janice, for that much applause. Back at you. Pete's Garage, you'll never guess where I ran into tonight after all these years. I ran into Todd. I mean Hank. I haven't seen him in years. He looks great. Great, really made my day, made my week, year, decade. Changed a bit. We had a ball. Saw him over at the Statler. I get no kicks from champagne. Mere alcohol doesn't thrill me at all. So tell me, why should it be true? I get a kick out of you.
I call it that scary place.
Some get a kick from that expensive cocaine. Good thing I'm too cheap. I'm sure that if I took even one sniff, it would bore me terrifically too. I get a kick out of you. I get a kick every time I see you standing there before me. I get a kick, though it's queer to me. You obviously don't adore me. I get no kicks from a play. Great to see Jim out there, sir. Flying so high, we're somewhere in the sky. It's my idea of nothing at all. I get a kick out of Jim.
See the baby, and we went up to it so I could look.
Yeah. What a view.
Oh, I heard it's incredible. I haven't been up there probably 19 people. Yeah, I heard the view is just incredible. I mean, the rooftop lounge on the cliff is nice, but this place is better.
It's higher.
Yeah, higher.
Yeah, higher. You can see.
Oh, I heard.
I like these after hours.
Yeah, I was seeing when they were advertising on Facebook when they first opened.
Smoky room.
Buildings you didn't know existed. Yeah, that's my son.
Bunch of drunk chicks with me. Piano.
Space, all space things opening and down.
We're downtown.
Really,
something about being downtown is just kind of exciting, isn't it? Even if there's nothing going on. Which there always is.
There is.
There was a big protest going, I guess, when some people came in, said there was a big...
I guess the building went out pretty well.
Hope they weren't protesting us.
Who had a protest?
Earlier this evening, some of the guests mentioned there was a big Niagara Square. We should have set up our Niagara Square protest supply booth.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
.com. I don't know why they protest there, because they'll protest there like on the weekend in Niagara Square, right? It's where you go to protest. And there's nobody for miles.
Nobody sees it.
There's nobody working. There's nobody there.
I know.
It's like a dress rehearsal or something.
It's funny at St. Anthony's Church, every once in a while we were procession. Nobody sees us. You go around the circle, you go around the block.
I see him, you know, so I wave my arms.
Oh, the St. Anthony.
Let him know I feel the...
Yeah, we've got a ton of things
there. I feel what they feel. Right, Margaret Fisher? Barbara Fisher. Here's a song I learned from Barbara Fisher. Still learning it from Barbara Fisher. It's such a beautiful song.
They're great people. I love those Italians. They're great. The Italian mass comes in after our mass. So if you leave, you know, we have our coffee hour, and after that, a lot of the time we sing the Italians. And I love it. I feel like
it's impossible. Hell, the sun will leave the sky. It's just impossible. It's impossible. Ask a baby not to cry. It's just impossible. And I hold you
closer
to
Count the second.
That's my friend Sue's.
Yeah, I like that church a lot.
That I never think of
my
you.
My uncle was pastor there.
Oh, how really impossible.
Yeah, the outlines.
Can the ocean keep from rushing to the shore? It's just impassable. If I had you, could I ever ask for more? It's just impossible. I would sell my very soul and not regret it.
No, they have a company of them in the sandal.
Or to live without your love is just impossible. Beautiful sign. Thanks for teaching of it to me, Barbara Fisher. Here's something from Shaft. Jim Giannici. Don't misunderstand. We are only strangers.
Thank you.
us. Nice to see you, sir.
The nights.
Is like a lovely tune.
A few months after that, we end up with
beware
a house for New Year's.
My foolish heart.
I thought I saw that. Oh,
how would
like, why
be ever constant
move?
Beware.
From St. Michael's, and he was holding a glass of red wine.
My foolish heart.
I never rented the house.
There's a line between love and fascination. Hard to see on an evening such as this. They both give the very same sensation. Close to mine. Beware, my foolish heart. But should our eager lips come by, then let the fire start. Peter Allen wrote this song.
And I remember I made the
we wanted it all. Passion without pain.
I don't even know if I know how to start it. What do you mean?
Sunshine without
rainy day. But it makes it beautiful because you go back and it's wasted on the young. You go back as an adult and you realize
we wanted it always.
Yeah.
You and me, we reach for the stars. The wind that was high, never giving in.
knowing that we could win the prize. I should have seen it in your eyes. Look, look how all our dreams came true. See how I got me. Baby, you've got you. Something deep inside, you and me, we weren't like the rest. We once were the best. Back when we were dumb, how did we become so smart? And learn to break each other's hearts. Well, thanks, Kathy. You and me. Something deep inside, you and me, we weren't like the rest. We once were the best. Look what we've become. Isn't it a crying shame? That we almost made it, but we wanted it all. Baby, you and me, we wanted it all.
What a great talent he was. Nothing could be better. WBIG-TV on my Facebook wall every Friday night from 7:15. We run like the trains. We've got a real tight schedule. 7:15 to 11. Or else. Was doing very well. The world was fine as far as I could tell. Suddenly I met you and I dreamed of gay amour. Dawn I woke up singing sentimental overture.
This heart of mine is dancing gaily now. I taste the wine of real romancing now. Crazy world has taken on a wonderful design. As long as life endures, it's yours, this heart of mine. This heart of mine. Here's the Janus. Turn right to it. Let's try this one. I took one look at you. That's all I meant to do. And then my heart stood still. My lips could move and talk, and yet my heart stood still. Oh, not a single word was spoken. I could tell. Connecticut Yankee.
Connecticut Yankee.
Darcy and Maggie and Mary. My name's Howard. Together we're the Lounge Cadets. Where did this 4 hours go? Plus the hour I did at the Statler before that. They just went up like, seemed like moments. You guys made it so much fun. See you next week at 7:15, and we'll do it all again. We invite our guests to stick around while I clean. Keep Mary company.
Howard cleans. I do not clean. We do not upset this apple.
I do everything. I wear all the hats. I don't make the pies though.
But you make the donuts.
I make the donuts one at a time, lovingly. Thank you, Barbara Fisher.
Ryan Bates.
You made it a lot of fun.
High champion. He's won the. There's a Black Rock pie competition that he's won 2 years in a row making this key lime pie. And that's what he
did. Oh,
and
he made it.
Yeah, we're making them. Yeah, that's right. He didn't eat the pie. He made the pie in the Black Rock pie competition.
Like to invite Jason and Nicholas to join us again next Friday. We start at 7:15. You can tune in and. We do all the old songs from the great masters. Well, we don't do them all. There's not enough time in a lifetime to do them all. Look at all these books, how voluminous it is. So many songs. Oh, they were from a club in Ohio, a men's club.
Oh, I didn't even know that. They were from a club in Ohio?
A men's club in Ohio, yes.
Oh,
neat.
I didn't know that. It's nice to have them there, men's club.
If those seat cushions could talk.
It's funny to think we're getting into the era when we get the fire going.
You do feel pretty, it's best like, you know, like a windstorm, because then you can appreciate it, because like, there's no creaking or anything, it's just, it's like a rock. Except that room, because there's a roof over that, a flat roof over the room over there, so you could hear things hitting it and stuff. That's, if it weren't for that, it would be totally quiet. Orchard Park?
That's still pretty new though.
I've heard of Orchard Park.
It's not too far, and now all the construction's over.
I read in the newspaper the other day, it used to be called, it used to be East Hamburg.
It did?
Oh, I didn't know that.
It was East Hamburg. I did not know that. Yes. Linda Appleby, did you know that Orchard Park used to be called East Hamburg?
Way back.
Way back. Well, how far back does that go? 1800s? Yeah, this wasn't Delaware Avenue. This was called, what was this? All the streets had different names originally.
They did.
Batavia Street, which is Broadway.
Brian Higgins changed all the names of the street. he just can't stop making improvements. Watching the end of Lounge Academy. Every part of Lounge Academy is my favorite part. This is the smoky part. There really isn't any smoke. You got to imagine that, but there should be smoke.
Should be smoke.
At the end of the night, yeah.
In the lounge again.
Yeah. We'll have to get some, like, health smoke to pipe in. Do they make something called health smoke?
Is it like dry ice?
Vape. We'll get some vape.
I haven't heard all this talk about vaping. I don't even know what vaping is.
It makes big clouds of smoke, though. You see some of these guys vaping? Walking around, they do it here, you know. And it's smokier than...
You can't even see their faces.
Oh, yeah, it's like a choo-choo train. It's kind of neat.
So is that the same as like the old electronic cigarettes? Or are they different?
It's a good question.
I have no idea.
Yeah, they used to... The first, like, they tried to make them look like cigarettes, right?
I have one, pipes and the tip lit up.
Would like glow? Oh, the tip even lit.
Well, I don't care.
It was like rolling your toaster up in a cigarette paper.
It's
like taking your toaster and rolling it up in your Easy Wires.
I still have it. You 60s
people will know what I'm talking about there.
You can't buy candy cigarettes anymore, I guess.
You can't buy candy cigarettes? Why not?
Yeah, they look like cigarettes.
Yeah, they look like cigarettes.
All the vices should have the toys to go with it. So that kids can, you know, learn about it.
The wax bottles, yes, I remember those too.
Oh, yeah.
The wax bottles.
Yeah. Rock candy, that stuff was health food. Solid crystals of sugar. With a choking string going through.
I know. I was just saying how funny it was to like Halloween, you come up with your teeth falling out.
Yeah. Halloween was great for dentists. The dentist must have sponsored that.
Unless you went to, what was his name? The dentist kind of staring. What was his name? Dr. Payne. He gave us apples.
Oh, yeah. Somebody was giving you apples.
And one little.
Without razors.
Without razors.
Yeah. That probably never happened even once, you know?
Yeah.
And he walked up to the door and rang the bell.
Shopping bags or something,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, remember that? We had a huge plastic pumpkin, so I think you could have held a whole lot. Yeah,
that
was funny.
I know that Pammy, now the Pammy, came over and said, oh, she said, you've just missed the funniest thing over at the Aidens.
Well, we're going to talk about Halloween, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see you, invite you to stop back again. Next week, we'll do it again. Right here on my Facebook wall, we call it WBIG TV.
My neighbor goes and hog wild.
My name's Howard.
At Halloween, my next door neighbor, he gets out a chainsaw.
With Mary, my wife, and co-host Mary Quinn's Goldman.
It's a huge thing, and sometimes the TV news comes out and covers it as Halloween. Oh, no. But no one pays attention to me at all. I'm right next door. And a few times over the years, but not anymore, to tell the truth. I've had candy and I've been ready, but I...
And we'll see you next week.
I think partly
I'm going to send
I'm on Amherst Street,
us off into the ether with my finger that has the power to not only create music, but I could destroy it.
We didn't go on streets where there
I'm going to do that right now.
You could do.
Yeah, it wasn't worth our while, you know, because you could
send you guys some...
Maybe there were doubles
things.
On both sides of the street, and you could...
Like when I was on Norwood last year, I
a little fireworks display of
10 or 11
icons, fingers, and
myself.
Hearts.
Yeah.
Oh,
I
haven't eaten it all yourself.
And now I'm going to do the dishes.
You ate it all. I know.
Because Rich Sellers is off tonight.
I ran out of candy.
He'll be back next week.
A couple times I've had maybe one or two trick-or-treaters, but then normally I just get none. I don't